Indonesia is the country with the fifth highest child stunting burden in the world and the second highest in Southeast Asia. Based on the Indonesian Toddler Nutritional Status Survey in 2019, the prevalence of stunting in Indonesia has reached 27.7%. This means 1 in 4 children under 5, more than 8 million children in Indonesia is stunted. The result of the survey showed that there is a decrease in stunting rate in Indonesia. The Ministry of Health announced the result of Indonesia Nutritional Status Survey at the BKKBN National Working Meeting, where the prevalence of stunting rate in Indonesia fell from 24.4% in 2021 to 21.6% in 2022. Although the stunting rate has decreased, the figure is still valuable considering that World Health Organization targets that stunting rate to be no more than 20%. The question is stunting dangerous? According to the World Health Organization, stunting is a developmental disorder in children caused by poor nutrition, repeated infection, and inadequate physiological stimulation. Stunting is a serious threat that anyone can experience. Stunting is not only experienced by poor families who are economically and psychologically unable to provide adequate nutrition. However, stunting can be experienced by well-off or wealthy family. Stunting can increase morbidity, delay motoric and cognitive development, and inhibit the brain growth. Impact of stunting hits the children and will continue to the adulthood. Children with stunting condition become more susceptible to infectious disease and at risk of degenerative disease when they grow up as adults. The problem of stunting is important to be solved because it can intrude the potential of human resource related to the level of health and possibly raise the child mortality. Prevention and reduction of stunting rates in Indonesia is not only a government matter. All elements of the nation must be involved and play an active role in combating stunting. Existing infrastructure and institutions must be mobilized to facilitate the solution of stunting issue. It should be begun with environments such as clean water, sanitation, and a healthy home. Solving the issue of stunting usually focuses on nutrition given to children, but many people forget the indispensable thing, namely the place of the entry of food or oral health. Stunting is closely related to oral health. Stunting can disrupt the growth of dentition teeth so that erupted teeth become more incomplete. Some studies also state that children who experience stunting condition are more at high risk of caries compared to children with adequate nutritional condition. Dental caries is a condition of chronic damage to the structure and layer of teeth. The process of caries begins with the erosion of the enamel or the outermost layer of the tooth.
As it is known that stunting condition and oral health has a reciprocal relationship, to prevent stunting, it is necessary to fulfill balanced nutrition and maintaining healthy teeth.
Therefore, let's prevent these two problems together in children by doing first, meet nutritional needs since pregnancy. 2. Provide exclusive breastfeeding until the baby is 6 months old and accompanied by healthy complementary food. 3. Monitor the child's development periodically. 4. Brush the teeth 2 times a day, after breakfast and before going to bed. Parents are expected to make the atmosphere of teeth brushing more comfortable and creative for the children. 5. Avoid the habit of drinking bottled milk before going to bed. And 6. Perform routine control to the dentist at least once every 6 months.
Children are the future of our nation. Let's prevent stunting by fulfilling balancing meal and maintaining healthy teeth and mouth. Prevent stunting towards Golden Indonesia 2045.